This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Brunetto Latini c. 1220-1294, who signed his name Brunectus Latinus in Latin and Burnecto Latino in Italian, was an Italian philosopher, scholar, notary, and statesman. Latini was Dante's guardian after the death of Dante's father. Contents: 1. Life. 2. Works. 3. The Divine Comedy. 31. Canto 15. 4. Notes. 5. References. 6. Sources. 7. External links. Life. Brunetto Latini was born in Florence in 1220 to a Tuscan noble family. The son of Buonaccorso Latini, he belonged to the Guelph party. He was a notary and a man of learning, much respected by his fellow citizens and famed for his skill as an orator. He expounded the writings of Cicero as guidance in public affairs. He was of sufficient stature to be sent to Seville on an embassy to Alfonso el Sabio of Castile to seek help for Florence against the Sienese. The mission was unsuccessful on his return from Spain. Traveling along the Pass of Roncesvalles, he describes meeting a student from Bologna, astride a bay mule, who told him of the defeat of the Guelphs at the Battle of Montaperti. As a result, Latini was exiled from his native city. He took refuge for some years, 1261-1268, in France, working as a notary, in Montpellier, Arras, Bar-sur-Aube, and Paris in 1269. When the political situation allowed, he returned to Tuscany and for some 20 years held successive high offices. In 1273 he was appointed as secretary to the Council of the Florentine Republic. In 1280, he contributed to the temporary reconciliation between the Guelph and Ghibelline parties, and in 1284 presided over the conference in which an attack on Pisa was agreed finally. In 1287, he was elevated to the dignity of prior, one of 12 magistrates established through the Constitution of 1282. Giovanni Villani says that he was a great philosopher and a consummate master of rhetoric, not only in knowing how to speak well, but how to write well. He was the author of various works in prose and verse. He died in 1294, leaving a daughter, Bianca Latini, who had married Guido di Filippo de Castiglionci in 1284. His tomb can be found in the church of Santa Maria Maggiore, Florence, to the left of the high altar. Works: Livres do Tresor. While in France, he wrote his Italian Tesoretto and in French his prose Les Livres do Trésor, both summaries of the encyclopedic knowledge of the day. The latter is regarded as the first encyclopedia in a modern European language. The Italian 13th-century translation known as Tesoro was misattributed to Bono Giamboni. He also translated into Italian the Rhetorica and 3 orations by Cicero. The Italian translation of Aristotle's Nicomachean Ethics is often misattributed to Brunetto Latini. It is a work of Taddeo Alderotti. Instead, the Divine Comedy. Latini was Dante's guardian after the death of his father. Early Dante commentators spoke of Brunetto as his teacher, as does Dante himself. Vittorio Imbriani took issue with that concept, saying Brunetto was far too busy a man to have been a mere teacher. Dante immortalized him in the Divine Comedy C. Inferno, 1582-87. It is also believed that there was an intellectual and affectionate bond between the elderly man and the young poet. It was perhaps Latini who induced Dante to read Cicero and Boethius. After the death of Beatrice, many of the characters in Dante's Inferno are also mentioned in the legal and diplomatic documents Brunetto Latini wrote in Latin. There is a portrait of Latini in the Bargello in Florence, once reputed to be by Giotto, beside the one of Dante in a wood engraving. Gustave Doré envisages the same scene from Inferno 15, 1861, Canto 15. Dante places Latini within the third ring of the seventh circle, the circle of the violent, with the blasphemers, suicides, profligates and sodomites, and writes of the clerks and great and famous scholars, defiled in the world by one and the same sin. Dante's treatment of Latini, however, is commendatory beyond almost any other figure in the Inferno. He calls the poet a radiance among men and speaks with gratitude of that sweet image, gentle and paternal. You were to me in the world when hour by hour, you taught me how man makes himself eternal. Dante addresses Latini with the respectful pronoun voi. Latini uses the informal too, as perhaps was their custom when they spoke together in Florence. The portrait is drawn with love, pathos and a dignity that is more compelling given the squalor of the punishment. Latini asks first, humbly, if he may keep Dante company, letting his group run on. Dante offers to sit down with him, but that would only increase Latini's penalty. He and the other souls are doomed to keep moving aimlessly around the arena. Latini proceeds in obscure imagery to foretell Dante's future future the malicious ingrates who of old descended from Fiesole, will be his enemies. They are reputed blind, avaricious, envious and proud. Let him beware, he warns, not to be stained by them. Mark Musa suggests that in this speech between the two there is sexual imagery indicative of the act of sodomy. According to John D. Sinclair, Dante respected Latini immensely but nonetheless felt it necessary to place him with the sodomites since, according to Sinclair, such behavior by Latini was well known in Florence at the time. The squalor of Latini's sin and penalty is nevertheless painful for Dante to visualize. Other critics point to the fact that, outside of the Divine Comedy, Latini is nowhere else accused of sodomy or homosexual relations, and indeed he seemingly condemns it himself in the Tesoretto. Some therefore have suggested perhaps that Latini is placed in Canto 15 for being violent against art and against his vernacular. Latini wrote in French instead of Florentine, which Dante championed as a literary language in De Vulgari Eloquentia, or perhaps also to demonstrate and underline that even the greatest of men may be guilty of private sins. Neither objection rules out the possibility that he was guilty of the perceived sin himself, and given the setting and context, it is difficult to see that there can be any doubt, particularly following the discovery in recent years of a love poem, Se o son distretto innamoratamente, which Latini may have sent to a man. Bondi di Teuti notes that this article includes a list of references, but its sources remain unclear because it has insufficient inline citations. Please help to improve this article by introducing more precise citations. January 2014. Learn how and when to remove this template message. ABC Chisholm 1911. Carrot Musa, Mark 1971, Dante's Inferno, Notes, Canto 15, Bloomington, Indiana, Indiana University Press, p. External links website on Brunetto Latino Authority Control WorldCat Identities VIAF, 19,680,057 LCCN, N8109-7516 ISNI, 0000-0001-2122-946 XGND, 118,516,108 Sudik, 0269-68088 BNF, CB1191122 236 V Data ICCU, IT ICCU, CFIV 060850 VE Dante works in Latin De Vulgari Eloquentia de Monarchia Eclogues. Works in Italian La Vita Nuova La Rime Convivio Divine Comedy Inferno Purgatorio Paradiso Books, Articles, Concepts Contrapasso Cultural References in Divina Commedia Dante Encyclopedia Encyclopedia Dantesca People in Dante's Life Aliero di Bellincioni Father Jacopo Alighieri Son Guido Cavalcanti Brunetto Latini Beatrice Portinari Dante in Popular Culture Dante Crater Dante Alighieri Academy Scuola Italiana Dante Alighieri Dante Park Italian Battleship Dante Alighieri Book, Dante Alighieri Category, The Divine Comedy